impulse of the steam jet. How the steam jet is formed? When the steam is passing through the nozzle, then the steam jet is formed. Then the steam jet strikes or impinges on the turbine blades, which are mounted on the circumference of the wheel. And after impinging, it glides over the concave surface of the blade and leaves the turbine. Let us understand how to draw velocity triangles of moving blade for an impulse turbine in a simple way. Now, if we observe this diagram, here is the turbine blade which is having linear velocity Vb. Point C is the entrance point of the steam jet and point D is the exit point of the steam jet for this blade. Now, one point that we have to note down, that is, steam jet enters to the turbine blade at this point C tangentially with absolute velocity V, and then it glides over this concave surface and leaves the blade at this point D tangentially with relative velocity Vr. So for that we have to draw two tangents, that is the tangent at point C and tangent at point D. So we will first complete that. So these are the two tangents. Now this is the direction of the steam jet. So how the steam jet is formed? So whenever the steam is passing through the nozzle, then the steam jet is formed. So here is the direction of steam jet. Now this steam jet is having absolute velocity V. So I will show here. So this is the direction of the movement and with velocity V. And then leaves this blade at this point D with relative velocity Vr. So whenever we show these notations, then for at the exit point we will use the suffix 1. So instead of Vr, I will use Vr1. So I will show direction also, that is Vr1. So this is according to rule. Now we will draw one horizontal component and one vertical component for this V, because V is in the inclined direction. So how to draw horizontal component? So if I draw here horizontal component, so I will draw here in a rough first with the help of the red marker. So if I draw here, then the direction should be in this direction, that is towards the right hand side for this V. And if I draw the vertical component, then direction is in the downward direction. Now instead of drawing the vertical component here, I will draw one after other, that is after horizontal component I will draw the vertical component. So first we will complete the horizontal component and then here we will draw the vertical component. Now what is this horizontal component? So for this horizontal component of V is nothing but the velocity of whirl, and that we have to show. So I will show here the velocity of whirl, that is V to the base W. So this is the indication. And the vertical component of V is nothing but the velocity of flow. So I will show here this is VF. Now I will show here this point, that is the point A, and here this point I will say point E. Now we have to show the relative velocity for this triangle. So Vr, that is the relative velocity of Z to the moving blade. So how to show that? So for that we have to select one point on this horizontal component in such a way that magnitude is equal to this Vb. Now if we observe, the direction of Vb is towards the right hand side direction, and the direction for this horizontal component is also in the same direction, that is towards the right hand side direction. Now we will select the magnitude of Vb and we will select here one point, that will be the point B. Now if I join this point B and point C, then this is nothing but the relative velocity Vr. So I will show here this is the relative velocity Vr. Now we will move for the angles. So here theta is the angle between VR and the direction of motion of blade. So this is the VR component and here is the direction of motion of blade. So this angle is known as theta. Then alpha. So it is the angle between V, that is this absolute velocity and direction of motion of blade. So I will show here the angle alpha. So in this way the velocity triangle at the entrance is getting completed. Now we will move to draw the velocity triangle at the exit point, that is at point D. So here is the relative velocity VR1. Now if we observe, the relative velocity VR1 is making an angle phi to the direction of the movement of this blade, that is VB. So now in the same direction, that is direction towards the right hand side direction, there is the angle phi, that is here is the angle theta. And in the same way we have to draw here the angle phi. So I will draw here with angle phi one horizontal line in the same direction for this VB. So here is the direction. So I will show here the angle phi. Now we have to draw the absolute velocity, that is here is the V. So similar to that we have to draw V1. Now if we observe, what is this magnitude for this point A and B? So if we observe, the magnitude is same, that is equal to the magnitude of this VB. So I will show this is VB. Now in the same way, suppose I will consider this is the point A, then we have to select one point that is having the same magnitude of VB. So for this magnitude of VB, I will select here one point, that is the point B, having magnitude equal to VB. Here is the point B. Now if I join this point D and point B, then here this is nothing but the absolute velocity of the steam jet at the exit point. Now we will show here the direction also, and this absolute velocity here is V. So in the same way we will show here with suffix 1, that is V1. Now for this absolute velocity again we have to draw the horizontal component and vertical component, because this is the in inclined direction. So how to draw? So in rough, with the help of the red marker, I will draw the horizontal component. So this is the inclined direction towards the left hand side. So we have to show the direction in this way for horizontal component, and for vertical component we have to show the direction in the downward direction. Now we will complete this triangle. So in the downward direction I will show vertical component. Now for this vertical component of V, that is for exit point V1, it is Vf, that is the velocity of flow. So I will show this is velocity of flow. And now if we observe, for the horizontal component it is Vw, but the direction is towards the left hand side direction. So here we have to show this direction. So I will show here the magnitude, that is nothing but equal to Vw, that is the velocity of whirl. So we have to show that. So in this point I will say point F. Then here for this horizontal component I will show here the direction, and for this component of V we have to show the direction for this Bf in the opposite direction, because if we resolve this component then direction is in the opposite direction. So this is the velocity triangle at the exit point of the turbine blade. Now we will understand how to draw combined velocity diagram with the help of one problem. I will read what is the given question. In a turbine, the steam enters the wheel through nozzle with a velocity of 500 meters per second and at an angle of 20 degree to the direction of motion of blade. Blade speed is 200 meters per second and the exit angle of moving blade is 25 degree. Find the inlet angle of moving blade, exit velocity of steam and its direction with the help of the combined velocity diagram. So this was the given question. Let us first understand what is the given data. So the steam jet enters with a velocity 500 meters per this is nothing but the absolute velocity of the stick, that is v, and it enters tangentially to the entrance point, and it is making an angle of 20 degree with the motion of the blade. So we know that this motion of the blade is the linear motion, and we have to show in horizontal direction. So first, as per this data, with absolute velocity v and this angle alpha, that is the angle made by v with the motion of the blade, is equal to 20 degree, we will draw here one construction diagram. Now we have to select some suitable scale. So scale should depends on the space available. So I will select here scale 1 centimeter is equal to 10 meter per second. So for this 500 meter per second, we have to take this scale, that is for 50 centimeter. Now I will select here one horizontal line. So suppose I will select one random horizontal point, and on this horizontal line I will select here one particular point, that is the point B. Now we have to show this absolute velocity V as well as angle alpha, that is equal to 20 degree. So how to show that? So I will take angle of 20 degree with reference to this selected line. So from this selected line we have to select here one angle 20 degree, and we will draw here one inclined line. Now this horizontal line indicates the motion of the blade, that is the always linear motion of the blade. So for that we will select here one horizontal line, and this inclined line is nothing but the absolute velocity v, which is having magnitude 50 centimeters. So here is the point B, I will select, this is the point C, and here is the V. Now main important thing is that how to select the direction of this V. Now we know that this steam Z enters from the nozzle to the entrance point of the blade. So suppose here is the blade and here is the steam Z that is entered in the blade. So here this is the direction. So we have to show the same direction, that is in the downward direction. So I will show here. Now after we select this direction, then we have to draw the horizontal component as well as vertical component, because this V is in the inclined direction. So first I will draw here in the rough, that is the two components. So here is the vertical component, so direction is in this downward direction, and here is the horizontal component, so direction is in the forward direction. So these are the two components. Now I will draw these components one after other. So first I will complete this vertical component, and this vertical component is nothing but VF. So we already know this vertical component is known as VF, that is the velocity of flow, and the horizontal component is known as the velocity of whirl. So I will complete this triangle. So here we will show this. Suppose I will say this point is E, then E to B, that is nothing but the velocity of whirl, that is VW. Then we have to show here the direction. So here this is the vertical component, and we have to show the same direction, that is the forward direction for this VW. So in this way this triangle is getting completed, that is the velocity triangle for the steam jet at the entrance of the blade. Now we have to show the relative velocity, that is VR. So how to show that? Now if we move forward, the velocity of the blade is given. So blade is moving in the linear motion, and its velocity is given 200 meter per second. So on this horizontal line we have to select the point in such a way that this VB is equal to 200 meter per second. So as per this scale we have to take here as a 20 centimeter. So from this point B I will select one point that is equal to 20 centimeter. So here with the help of this scale we have to select one point at 20 cm and that is the point A. Now this distance from A to B is known as the VB. So we have to show this distance, that is nothing but VB. Now we will complete this. If we join this point A and point C, then it is nothing but the relative velocity, that is VR. So we have to show this VR. And here this angle is nothing but the angle alpha, that is equal to 20 degree. And here the VR is making an angle theta with this direction of motion of the blade. So this triangle is getting completed. Now again, if we move for the next, at the exit point, the direction of the steam jet is making an angle of 25 degree. Now again, we will observe this diagram. Here is the steam jet enters to the blade. Then it glides over the concave surface of the blade and then it exits tangentially. So we know that the steam jet exits tangentially with relative velocity VR1. And this at the exit point, it is making an angle of 25 degree to the motion of the blade. So again, the motion of blade is in the horizontal direction. And here is the horizontal direction and this angle is known as the angle phi. So here we have to show this phi with VR1. So here angle phi is equal to 25 degree. So at this point A, we will show here this angle is 25 degree. Now magnitude is not known. So for this VR1, what is the magnitude? That is not known. Now, what is the direction of this VR1? That is in the downward direction. Now, I will show here the angle 25 degrees. So, from this point A, that is from this line, we have to select one point at 25 degrees and we will select here or draw here one line. And this angle is 25 degrees. And here is VR1. So this is the component is known as the relative velocity at the exit point. Now what about the direction? So in the same direction we have to show here. So this is the direction of VR1. Magnitude of VR1 is not given. So for that we have to take A as a center and in compass we will take the distance AC. And we will draw here one arc. So this arc cuts this VR1 at point D. So this point D, that is if we measure this distance in between AD, then this is the magnitude of the relative velocity at the exit point. Now this distance AB is nothing but VB. So if we join this point B and D, then it will be the absolute velocity at the exit point. So we will join these two points. Now what is the direction? So direction should be for this V1, we know that it is in the downward direction. So again we will show this direction and here is the V1. Now again, what is the important point? That we have to resolve this component, that is V1. So in the horizontal component as well as vertical component. So first I will resolve this in rough. So here is inclined direction. So this is the vertical component. Here is the direction and this is the horizontal component and here is the direction. Now we will draw these two components one by one, that is one after other. So first I will complete this vertical component. So here is the direction and this is known as the velocity of flow, that is VF1. And then we will complete this horizontal component and that will be the velocity of whirl, that is VW1. So direction is towards the left hand side. So this is the direction. So we will say this will be the point F and we will show the distance from B to F, that is nothing but VW1. This combined velocity triangle optical diagram is getting completed. Now we will move for the question. So first point is that we have to find out the inlet angle of moving blade. So inlet angle of moving blade, that is for this the diagram at the entrance, if we observe this angle theta is equal to 32 degrees. Then the next is exit velocity of steam. So exit velocity of steam, that is this V1. So if we measure this, we will get it is 16.5 centimeters. So we have to convert in meter per second, that is 165 meters per second. And then the direction of exit steam. So direction of exit steam, that is the angle beta, and that is equal to 59 degrees.